for the Reese Bee, the best channel on YouTube.
In this week's video, I'm wearing a hat because my hair is a right mess and I shan't be taking any more questions on that matter. In my hands today, though, I have a book that I believe is the most important book in the history of the world. It's this, The Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carle. Now firstly, I want to talk a bit about the man who wrote the book, Eric Carle. Unfortunately, he passed away last week at the age of 91, which was what inspired me to make this video and talk about this book. As a child, it was one of my favourite books ever, as I imagine it was for loads of people all across the world. And Eric Carle, as a man, obviously I never met him, I never got to know him, but he just seemed like the nicest guy in the world. All you need to do is have a look at his website. If you go on there, there's all these things you can download entirely for free. They've got things such as cards, colorings, games. There's all sorts that you can download entirely for free. Loads of people will make you pay for that in some kind of activity pack, but he just thought, you know what, have all this for free, which is wonderful. Also on his website, something that I absolutely love, is a frequently asked questions section of the webpage where questions that kids have asked him over and over and over again, he just put the answers up on there. There's questions such as, have you got any brothers and sisters? What's your favourite colour? How do you grow a beard? And my personal favourite question that is on there is this bit here on the Very Hungry Caterpillar, is that a nose or a mouth? And he answers it in the greatest way possible. He says, in real life, caterpillars don't have noses, but mine does. So that right there, confirmed, that's a nose. He even has his own museum in Massachusetts, which if I'm ever in the area, I'll go check out. Another fantastic thing about Eric Carle is not only did he write the books himself, but he did the illustrations from as well. Like you can see here, there is some iconic images from my childhood on every single page of this book. And he wouldn't just use paper and paints and stuff, he would use little bits of tissue paper and put them in there, he would use bits of carpet, he would just have really creative ways of making his images that have inspired millions of people across the world to make the images in the way that they want them. I can imagine there's lots of artists around the world today who can trace their love of art back to this book and seeing the pictures in this book here. Now the book itself was released in June of 1969, and the idea for it came to Eric Carle when he was playing around with a hole punch, just putting holes in pieces of paper, and he thought about a little worm eating holes in paper. And he wrote a book called A Week with Willie the Worm, and he took that to his agent and said, look, I've made this book here, and the agent said, kids hate worms, make it a caterpillar. And Eric Carle went, you know, that's a good idea. And at the end, we can turn it into a beautiful butterfly. So he did. And apparently it was very difficult to get this published, as there wasn't many places in the US where they could make the book have the holes in the pages for the caterpillar eating the fruits. So they ended up shipping it out to Japan, I believe. They made the book in Japan, then shipped it all worldwide. And when I say worldwide, I mean worldwide. This book has been translated into 40 different languages. It sold 50 million copies across the world, and it's reported that every 30 seconds, a copy of this book gets sold. George Bush, the former president, even said that this is his favorite book ever made. So that's a lot about the history of the book and the history of the man. But what makes this book so important to me and why I think it's so important to other people is that you can learn so much from this book. It's only 22 pages, there isn't even many words on the pages, and I think that's a bonus in itself, because if you are a child and you're not very good at reading, when you see here, look at that big old page there, and there's only a few words there in the bottom corner. It's not intimidating, and they're simple words as well. The first section of the book, in the light of the moon, a little egg lay on a leaf. Very simple words there, and it teaches you words. That's what you want for your children as a child. You learn these words here, then it also goes on to teach you numbers. For example, one apple, two pears, three plums, four strawberries, five oranges. On top of that, days of the week, we learn. The caterpillar was born on a Saturday. We then learn the next day was Monday, when he ate the apple, Tuesday the pears, Wednesday the plums, Thursday the strawberries, Friday the oranges, and Saturday the big old mess. And speaking of the big old mess, there's another learning lesson here. This here teaches you, in a way, nutrition. You learn here from this little hungry caterpillar that if you decide to eat a piece of chocolate cake, an ice cream cone, a pickle, a slice of Swiss cheese, a slice of salami, lollipop, a piece of cherry pie, a sausage, a cupcake, and a slice of watermelon, you will have a stomachache. Look how sad our little hungry caterpillar is. Do you want to be that sad? No, don't eat that rubbish. What you need to eat are your greens. There you go, because the next day was Sunday again, and the little caterpillar ate through one nice green leaf. And after that, he felt much better. And then the final thing the book will teach you was the thing that blew my mind when I was a child. And that is the life cycle of a caterpillar, because he becomes, in the words of the book, a big, fat caterpillar who has a sleep in a cocoon. And when he wakes 2 weeks later, he is a beautiful butterfly. And as I said, when I was a child and I learned that caterpillars became butterflies, that blew my mind. But there is also a deeper message to the book. And that is a message overall of hope. About how one day you might make mistakes and feel very bad about it. But your history does not define you. And if you make the right decisions, eventually you will become a beautiful butterfly. Just like I've made a bad decision of not getting my hair cut. But maybe one day I'll make the right decisions and become a beautiful butterfly myself. Maybe that'll be in next week's video. So subscribe. But I will also let you know, I haven't got a haircut booked in and I don't plan one, so I'll have to just like brush it or something. So I guess I'll see you then. Goodbye.